Ronnie's an old friend. He's a tiny bit eccentric, I guess. Around here, we say they're set in their ways.
Boy, wouldn't that have been something back in the damn liquor hauling days when they was getting away from Malawi.
Oh, Lord.
Lord have mercy.
Well, what's on your mind today, Ronnie?
I've got a special request. I'd like to see if you guys would make me a special round of Kentucky bourbon. I'd like to have some of the finest bourbons ever been made.
It'd be Tennessee bourbon.
Close enough.
You don't drink. What are you wanting liquor for?
This is going to be something special. This is going to be for my funeral.
Funeral liquor?
Funeral liquor, yeah.
Our liquor may have been drank at funerals before in the past, but we have never intentionally made a funeral liquor.
You ain't feeling bad, are you?
No, because I feel great, but the time's coming.
Well, we can do that. You're going to have to stretch out about 3 more years. You can't be dying out before then. You just got to age for 3 years.
Digger knows more about this mash process than anybody, so.
Well, the number one thing, the grain bill has to be at least 51% corn.
And has to be limestone water.
Yeah.
The water in any liquor, it's the do-all, end-all. And in bourbon's incidence, it needs to be limestone water. Well, how much now are you talking about? Just a 5-gallon barrel or something?
6-gallon keg?
You want white corn, yellow corn?
What about that Indian corn?
Well, I ain't ever made no liquor out of it, but I've heard that it works.
Indian corn, very, very expensive. I've never given any thought to making any liquor out of it.
Money's not going to be any problem. I just got one shot at this.
Yeah, we
exactly.
Don't.
Now, this needs to be really filtered. Can you do that for me?
You want it really mellowed out.
I want it smooth.
We'll get started on it,
brother. All right.
This run, it's going to require extra steps of work. We got to find the correct corn. We got to shell the corn. But who knows? Maybe me and Digger's just set us up in a new line of liquor, funeral liquor.
That looks about right.
Hell, it ain't against the rules to get you a bucket of water, is it?
No, people's used this water for years.
In Cock County, Tennessee, with a limestone spring easily accessible, Mark and Digger need to tote enough water back to their site to mash in.
Me and Mark are gonna get us a little limestone water right out of this bank where this spring comes out these old limestone rocks.
Wow, I've lived here my whole life and never knowed that was there.
Earlier in the season, while searching out a still site, Digger showed Mark this same spring, but the location was less than ideal.
It's fine water, ain't it?
Cold as Eskimo's butt.
Limestone water's got just enough basic minerals in it where it makes the finest liquor in the world. Your mash will ferment to its best capacity and as fast as possible.
It's sweet, it's sweet.
Just makes a more mellow liquor. Flavor comes through a little better. Big distilleries in Kentucky, they'd have a battle over this spring right here. They'd love to have it. We've got it in our backyard right here on the main drag in town.
We got a barrel here, baby man. Let's get out of here.
Let's do it.
We're going to get it going. We're going to go to the still site and mash in with our Indian corn. We've got it ground. We've got the limestone water. You know, ain't this a hell of a thing, hauling a tote of water.
To water.
To water.
I don't know whether it makes any difference or not, but we're going to see. Get them buckets out. Let's start handing it over and get this run of mash done.
You know, we're going to see what we can make out of it and hopefully make Ronnie proud. Not that he'll ever know it, but, you know, we're going to try. Indian corn.
First for both of us.
That is pretty, ain't it? Wonder why we ain't never come to us to do Indian corn before.
Maybe you just didn't think about how much it cost. This is the most expensive corn we've ever run in our life. It's a dollar an ear. I mean, normally you're looking at maybe 10, 12 cents an ear. It's ridiculous. Whether this makes good liquor or whether that might contribute to damn hallucinations, we don't know, but we'll find out. Shake a little of that in there, about half that. Let's stir it in. Man wants to be careful. We don't want to scorch this, that's for damn sure. We're taking a little bit extra pains in this mash. It's a special liquor for a special man.
A man don't need no damn fighting liquor at a funeral.
No, there's enough that goes on, they read the will. I'm gonna tell you what, when they look down upon me, I want them to nearly puke. Say, that needed to die.
So you've got about 3 more days left in you, huh?
3 more days and I'm about there.
I mean, this ain't about yield.
No.
We just gotta have really good 3 or 4 gallons of it, hopefully 5. Stir this up and the sugar dissolved. We just got to take our time with it. This has got to be loving liquor, no mean liquor. I'm really feeling. I feel good about it.
Boy, it does smell pretty.
Well, that corn, it cooked up pearly white. Look at that.
Look at it, how pretty it is in there.
I'm telling you what, that's about good enough spoon out the bone eat, ain't it?
Hell yeah. You're the man. Let's top it off with the rest of this water. Damn Ronnie Buckner's gonna have the finest liquor at his farewell party it's ever been. If that turns out anything like I think it is, it's gonna be damn primo.
I hope we got a little extra for me and you.
Ours probably won't make it till we're dead.
I'm ready to make a little wiki.
Little funeral wiki.
Yeah, the best kind if you ain't the damn recipient.
In Cock County, Tennessee, Mark and Digger are about to discover whether their limestone water and Indian corn funeral mash is ready to run or ready to bury.
Ain't that pretty? Damn if it ain't got some alcohol in it.
It's high octane.
The mash is good to go. Still has a little bit of the pink tint to it due to the Indian corn.
We got people at a fever pitch for Popcorn Sutton Legacy Liquor. We've got Daniel waiting. But first and foremost, we just need to finish this run of liquor.
We got to mock this bad boy up first.
I know it. We got a lot of work to do today. We got 2 truckloads of stuff, the steel itself, barrel staves to burn to make the charcoal for the filter. Run it back this way, put more. There you go. It's a little bit side-goggling, but it's all right.
We're going to get this mash transferred over in this little steel.
I'll tell you what, it looks kind of like a pink lemonade.
Yeah, when we cooked that husk up on them dark red ones, it made it pink.
You know, Digger and I, we've never had any pink tanned mash. This is our first attempt at ever making any liquor with Indian corn. It's very expensive. We hope it works. Let's get a rip there,
please. Let's get this up here, too. Make her go. Here we go. I'll be the wood guy, you be the barrel guy.
It's full of mud. One of the requests that Ronnie had was he did want it filtered over all new charcoal.
Watch him twerk. Them moves. Got more moves than X-Lax.
Nothing better to make it out of than the old oak barrel staves from whiskey barrels. I hope Ronnie appreciates all of the damn work we're going through to do this for him.
If he don't, he oughta. When you burn these coals up properly, hey, you want it to do is just to collapse down into a barrel. They'll burn down to that point you douse them with water.
And all this char has little microscopic grooves and cracks in it that removes fusel oils.
Fusel oils are a combination of many different kinds of alcohol, chiefly amyl alcohol. The charcoal mellows the liquor and gives it a better flavor. When they start crumbling up like that right there, that's when they're proper. The way we're going to put this charcoal filter together, we've got our tube, we put a base in it, we drilled holes in it, then we'll put felt in the bottom on top of that, and then we'll start piling charcoal in about 4 inches deep. Once we get to that point, we think we've got enough filtration where Ronnie will be satisfied with his liquor. We could buy these up, make them, and sell them on the moonshining market.
There we go.
Looks like a drain in the bottom of a tub, don't it?
It does, don't it? It's pretty simple, but I think it'll be very effective.
I don't think it could be anything but effective. There she blow.
Funeral liquor, here we go.
Squirting out there like a cow pissing on flat rock.
Yeah, boy. We put a tremendous amount of work in making this funeral liquor for Ronnie. Oh, that's plenty of heads, ain't it?
Yeah.
We don't know yet if it's worth a damn or not, but we'll know here in a minute.
Well, up jumped the devil. There's a full one.
They fill up pretty quick. That's an excellent stream of liquor off this little
good
pot.
Good stream of liquor. That some gun staying cold. Holy moly. That's got a nose like I ain't never seen.
Well, tell me that's good as I hope it is.
They hell for him. It's horrible. That's the best liquor I've ever tasted in my life. It's got a flavor. It's unbelievable.
Boy, that ought to make the funeral gods even happy, shouldn't it?
It's gonna put a new damn twist on the word funeral. The flavor is just so more pronounced in this Indian corn. I mean, if it was feasible, hell, I'd run it every time.
Take it a while to get down through there.
I'm gonna tell you what, running through that much charcoal, that's gonna be smoother than a turtle's back, ain't it?
He told us right off the bat that money didn't matter, and we spent a lot to do it, but Digger and I decide that it will cost $3,000.
Damn shame it's gonna have to take a death to get this thing cracked open again. The $600 a gallon price tag doesn't ring as outrageous in our minds once we consider the fact we're housing the liability for the rest of his life. We're gonna keep this liquor and let it age and bring it to him at the time of his funeral. You know, that being said, with everything else we've got invested in, that's pretty much a bargain. There we go. Perfect.
God almighty, he's gonna be so proud.